number of men diagnosed with prostate cancer increases every year. In our McLaren Medical Minute, we learn about robotic prostatectomy treatment, how it reduces blood loss and recovery time, but also treats patients with kidney cancer.
I'm Dr. Harold Rutila. I'm a urologist. I've been practicing at McLaren for over 19 years. Robotic prostatectomy has become the number one patient choice for treatment of newly diagnosed prostate cancer. What patients have come to expect is the opportunity to be cured of their prostate cancer with surgery, with less blood loss, with shorter hospital stays, and quicker recovery times. Robotic prostatectomy allows the surgeons to place instruments through very small incisions. The surgical field is magnified, and the operating instruments are much smaller than standard operating instruments. This allows for better visualization of the prostate and also the small blood vessels and nerves that accompany the prostate. This translates into better surgery, better outcomes for patients, and quicker recovery times. With robotic technology, we're able to treat patients with kidney tumors as well. Many patients with kidney cancer will have small tumors within the kidney. Using robotic technology, we're able to remove the cancerous portion of the kidney and preserve the normal renal tissue. This is beneficial to many patients who may have diabetes or hypertension or may have conditions that put them at risk for diminished renal function in the future. By removing only the cancerous portion of the kidney and preserving the good portion of the kidney, this allows patients a better opportunity to preserve their renal function long term. Here at McLaren, we're proud of our work with robotic prostatectomy and our new developments with kidney surgery. We're continually looking for new technologies that both enhance the patient experience and improve their post-operative recovery and well-being.
For more information on this story, visit McLaren.org. You can also find a link to that website on our website, abc12.com. And now, here's Leslie.